So hello guys and welcome to a very different type of video today. Now it's a bit clickbaity, yes the title is, but I want to show you this 40 goal a season striker that I've had at Alfreton Town for two seasons now, and he's scored over 80 goals in those two seasons. The man I'm talking about, you can see him right here, is a young man called Alex Babos. Now he was released by Derby County under 23s and snapped up by Alfreton. Now down in real life as a sort of winger slash attacking midfielder, I've played him as a striker on FM21 and he's absolutely delivered the goods for me. Now, over the Christmas period, I've not released a lot of videos, but I've been playing with my Alfreton Town team. I've actually played a little bit longer than I should have and finished another season. And as per usual, I lost in the Vanarama National League playoffs. But if it wasn't for this man, I wouldn't be anywhere near the playoffs. He's really kept me in a job. So we're now going to dive into the stats, have a look at why you should be signing this man for your lower league side. So here is then the man of the moment, Alex Babos. He's now 24 in game, so we're 2 years on. Capped at under 21 level for Wales, and he's been playing as an advanced forward for me during my time at Alfreton. Now, I've played him as an advanced forward on his own up top. I've also played him as an advanced forward as a two. So he's done all that. I haven't really played him as a number 10 because my formation hasn't allowed it. If you did want to play him as a number 10, he's more than capable of that, being a shadow striker or an advanced playmaker or just an attacking midfielder. Or if you want to play him in the centre of your midfield, maybe stick him as a mezzala. Let him break from midfield. He will score goals and create chances in all positions. If we just go back to that, stats-wise, dribbling of 8, finishing of 11, first touch of 10, passing of 10, technique 11, composure 11, acceleration, agility, pace and stamina. He's fairly professional. He's developed through the first couple of years. I'm excited to see how far he can develop. And he's played over nearly 100 games for me now. Well, 85 games for me, scoring 81 goals. I can't speak highly of him enough. If we go into the reports, now our coach report, now Alan Smith is our assistant manager at Alfreton, and he's got a decent level of judging player ability and potential. Now he reckons at this point in time, he's a good player for most Vanarama national sides. Now that's the league above where we are. And he's got the potential to be a decent League Two striker in the future. He's naturally in several positions and he's performed well in training. So he is going to develop because he is a keen trainer as well. Handles himself in a fairly professional manner and he's considered a physical player. Now you come on to the cons, and I can't say I agree with this. He doesn't feel comfortable playing in big matches. Over those two seasons, we have played in some big matches and he has come up with the goods. Admittedly, we've had one playoff semi-final that clearly didn't go well, as they never do with me. And he didn't produce in that. Maybe that's one downfall for him, but I wouldn't be so sure. Inconsistent, that's absolute rubbish. He's not inconsistent at all. The only inconsistency there is he doesn't score free a game all the time. And he tends not to get stuck into rough challenges, but really, if he's scoring that amount of goals, are we fussed? Maybe as we went up the leagues, that would become more of a problem. But as we found, it's not been that much of an issue. So if we look at his history, he was at Derby as a young man. He's gone on loan to Spain, got himself a nice suntan, come back to Derby, then had a quick loan spell at FC United of Manchester, where he's only made 6 appearances. Now, this is before, obviously, we took over in FM21 with Alfreton. In his first season, you can see he scored 38 goals in 39 games, making 7 assists and winning the Man of the Match award 7 times, with an average rating of 7.28. Now, that was an unbelievable season. And that was a season in which we finished 17th. That's important to note because he's not been scoring goals in that. He wasn't scoring goals in a team that was flying high and that was smashing everything before him. He was literally probably the reason why we weren't deep in a relegation battle. He was scoring goals consistently for a poor, poor side. Then we had a total summer rebuild. Now, I didn't think we were going to manage to keep Alex Babos in that summer. As he was on a non-contract as well, there was no transfer fee or anything like that, but we did manage to keep him. And in his second season, he played 46 times for us, scoring 43 goals with 4 assists and 12 Man of the Match awards. He actually upped his average rating to 7.33. Now, we've got another season at this level, and Alex Babos has now been signed to a full-time deal on £775 a week. He will cost nothing like that at the start of the game. If you get in early on a non-contract agreement, you will get him for next to no. And even on a part-time contract, I think you were only on 300 quid, which isn't a massive chunk of your wage budget. Maybe it is, but if it is, I'm sure the 40 goals will more than pay for that £300 a week. He's destined to go on to bigger and better things. Do I think that he's going to manage to become a full Wales international? Probably not. But as a lower league player, a young man who can develop and who can play several positions in your attacking central areas, maybe you could even train him to play on one at wings as an inside forward if you wanted. There is that option as well. He's got more than got the ability to do it. Then I think you've got plenty of options. So definitely, if you are looking for a striker to score you goals at this level, make sure that this man is one that your scouts are having a look at. I hope you've enjoyed that very different type of video today. It's been quick, it's been snappy, something a little bit different, but I needed to talk about this man because, and I'm not going to say I've scouted him, I've done this, I've done that, I haven't. I've dropped on him at Alfreton and just been absolutely in awe with him. I have not been in awe of a striker like that since Robbie McDonald last year at Real Madrid and Atalanta. So this man has been an absolute godsend for me. I'm sure he would be a godsend for you. If you have enjoyed this, something a little bit different, please do leave a like and subscribe. I hope you've all had a fantastic Christmas and are looking forward to the new year. I think we're all looking forward to getting rid of 2020, aren't we? But enjoy the festivities as much as you can, and we shall see you on the next video. See you later.